Hello, everybody. This is RedMcNed, and welcome back to the saga. And I've got some good news. I finished the wall. It was a doozy, but it's done. And also, I'm starting in a hole because, well, it's good to change things up every so often. Well, it seems all quiet on the northern side tower. Noon. As I walk along this tower, along this wall, I can't help but think. On one side, the happy lives of the folk of this town, sleeping restless. Sleeping peacefully, I mean. On the other side, the great unknown. The evils of the world, still at large. It makes me wonder, how long has this wall been here? And are we truly safe in here? And what's the cost of our safety? And it would really suck if I fell off, because there's no way I'd have to go around. So I must say, I am really happy with how this turned out. Because there's just like such a stark, extreme difference between this side, the side of civilization that's all lit up, and this other side that's just like, there's like monsters and stuff because I haven't lit it up at all. It's, oh no, I didn't, okay. I really didn't want to do that. Good time to see just what's over here. I didn't light it up, so there's a bunch of crap probably. am I still being followed? You know what? I like this. This is good. This is supposed to basically symbolize the danger of the outside world. Everything beyond this this wall. See the sheep? The sheep chose the wrong side. Man, I'm so glad that creeper didn't blow up. I really don't. You know, this, I love this wall, but it took forever to make. And now it's going to take forever to get around. Maybe not too long. I didn't really know what to do for the ends, because I didn't, you know, it can't extend forever. So I ended up putting these towers kind of way out in the water, just to dissuade anything from swimming around them. And just because I need the continuity, you probably never, ever, ever see this. I went ahead and brought these all the way down. Just makes me happier, you know? I get to sleep better at night. Oh, by the way, when you're building down here and placing blocks, you find yourself not with a Respiration 3 helmet. Your air's getting low. You think, man, it's a hassle to go back up there. Do I really need to breathe? Just take a torch. Do that. Oh, yeah. We are professional. So as I've said many times by now, I really like this wall. And one of the reasons why is that I feel like I kind of fleshed out everything I really wanted to. Like, I worked hard to try to figure out, well, how is this going to change elevations? How is it going to, you know, have the, I had to redesign a few things to make it work. Like, the sides are done a little differently. And also, I figured out what to do to make the ground look more natural to me. Like, it changes, and I think that the support systems should change as the ground changes. So, what I wanted to do really quickly is I saved this little spot over here just to show you my method, because there's a lot of different changes over here. And I, I want to show you my method. I want to share it with you. So I look mostly to these tree pillars to see what I should do with the design for the wall. If it's three or less, I don't do anything. If it's four, I'll put little half slabs here. And if this is showing, then I'll go ahead and replace this just to have it go down all the way. If there's five, I'll take the lowest one down and put a stair. And, well, can't have this right here. If that's, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I still put this on 5. So I think these are all going to be up here. I like this one. This is going to give me a lot of room to show what happens. Whatever I put down, I usually bring it down. So I can go ahead and be safe doing this. The wall design, I try to keep it on top, very similar as everything. So it's that. A right side up stair. And two blocks with a stair in front and stone walls on the sides. Now for these, I go ahead and bring them down. No difference. I just keep bringing them down. But for these, I like to sort of vary it up and do something like that. Trying to think. I think this is all that I usually do. If this was a scenario where, let's say, the wall was like this, then I would go ahead and do something like that. So for each height that the wall could possibly be, I've sort of worked out a solution. And the key to good builds, in my opinion, is staying consistent with your solutions. Like if there's this much wall to deal with, then this is what I'll do. And it's kind of, it can be arbitrary, or it could be whatever you decide it to be. Like, I'll show another section over here, if I can get to it. I can't. Like, this section has a lot more height to it, so I started to add more options for if it gets longer. So, for one of these one of these tree towers, I did the steps, and I still had more room. So if this ended up being 3 tall, I went ahead and put a stone fence there. That's what that is. Just to kind of give it that extra support on any tree pieces. And so that's what's going on over here. And I went ahead and put a stair afterwards, and I was going to basically treat it like one of these. Just make another one of these if it got too tall. But since it didn't have to. But I did have a pattern to follow, so whenever it didn't really matter what height from the ground this was, I was going to figure out a way to do the supports that would make sense. I was just branch mining, and I had to turn this on because I think I found something that is most rare and beautiful and natural. Perhaps you can hear it a little bit. When I go over here, I think there's a slime in here, which means that there's. Yep, there it is. Which means there may be a slime chunk. I have to take care of that. Okay. That was a very. That creeper waited a while, you know? It was just like kind of relishing how much it surprised me now that we've calmed down. The reason why this is exciting, and not just because I get a kick out of myself, and oh no, we lost those. Just another chance to show off the wonderful humor stylings of yours truly, is I think that there's a slime chunk here. And besides looking it up with other programs and stuff, it's really difficult to find slime chunks. But if you look on the third one down, it says chunk. It's very possible that, I guess the lines here goes 15 and then 0. It's very possible that one of these is a slime chunk. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to prepare the area for a little test, just to see which chunk actually is making slimes. Alright, I think that this is about ready to show you all what I'm up to, what I'm doing. This is basically my attempt to... This is just for convenience. To isolate the chunks. Now, I have on here... If you look at the XYZ, it says the coordinates. If you look two down from that, you see chunk. It should go 15, 14, 13, blah, 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 all the way down to 0. However, if you go this way, the other one counts up to 15. So this is the chunk. I went down to Y equals 11 to hollow it out. I think it's either this chunk or the one right next to it. So, to determine that, I have these two rooms ready. They both are the same shape. And they're both pretty isolated. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of hang around the area. Maybe try to find some caves and light them up. Just help with the spawn rates and whatnot. And I'll come back and check here and see if one of these has slimes in it. Alright, so I've been coming to and fro there and back again to this place, and I've been here having plenty of spawns, but no slimes. So actually, I went online and found a spawn slime chunk locator, and saw that neither of these were actually slime chunks. And I think it's more like there's maybe one next to this over here, and like one over there's really close by too. So, oh well, at least I put out there that this is one way you can do the trial and error to find these. If I wasn't using chunk finders, I would just incorporate the next ones of these and make a cell for them to spawn in like this. But since that takes a lot of time and is not really that fun, I'll just be honest, it's not that much fun, I'm just gonna... find one that's kind of a nice spawn chunk slime area that's closer than 400, 360, you know. Something that's closer, just so we can get our slime blocks taken care of. I did a little research, and it turns out that, like, one in every 7 or 8 chunks is a slime chunk. So if you had, like, a group of, like, 100 chunks, like a 10 by 10 area of chunks, odds are that, like, somewhere between 10 and 15 of those will be slime chunks. So I'm sure I can find one closer to me than where that was. Because I'm closer to 0-0 over here. Oh, I'm just kidding. Actually, that's weird. Spawn's usually like 0-0. This is pretty much where I came into this world. Huh. It's like 200, 250. But anyways, I decided to put that off because it's actually, they aren't as rare as I thought. I don't really need slimes or to make sticky pistons or anything just yet. I think I will soon when I start going into the next stage in this whole thing, which is just getting more and more industrialized and getting lots of blocks so I can build bigger and bigger things. But that can wait, I think. Oh, that's a really cool shot. I should take a picture of this. Yeah. Oh, this place had a... I like this place at night. It's really contemplative. I'm really contemplative when I'm here, that is. I think it's worth showing a progress report. Whoa, I almost... Sorry if that was loud. I really almost fell. Honest. So I might as well show a progress report. This keeps going down and down. And I'm getting more and more stones and stuffs out of it. But other than this and making the wall... Oh, hello. Other than these things, these have been taking a long time and a little bit of strip mining. I don't think I really have that much to show in this episode. So besides that... So this might actually, for the first time in ever, be a really short episode. Oh, never mind. Never mind. Look what I just found. I'm actually really surprised that I did not find this sooner because this is a place I've been exploring quite thoroughly, actually. That leads right into the quarry just right over there. So, looks like we got some of this going on. So this looks like a lovely mine shaft, and even better is it's actually where I'm standing at level 16 right now. So this has got some low mines going on if we look around. Now, these places are amazing for finding diamonds and other fun stuffs. So I hope you brought what you need, your lunchbox and a little stuff to write home to your parents while we go on a little adventure and see what's around here. But anyways, you're gonna see me run around a lot, 'cause that's how I cave, and I'm also gonna be putting torches on the walls the same way I cave. I pick a side, I choose left, you decide whenever you do yours. Well, instantly that's pretty interesting, 'cause we're now going into never mind. Not interesting at all. Okay. Moving on. That was going into a really low level. There was only one time that I went through a place like this, a mine shaft that is, and actually found one that went all the way down to level 2. And that kind of blew my mind. And that was back when Void Fog was in the game. And that really just made it that much spookier, because once you're down to that level, you really can't see anything. And all right, time to exercise a couple of my principles. I don't waste my time much with these because they block my view, so just get rid of them. And I don't waste much time with these either. Just random walls that have no reason for existing. All it's gonna do is make me lost. So, problem solved. Oh wait, does Silk Touch on pick? Silk Touch on pick work with spider webs. I forgot I wanted to use these for the clock tower. It probably won't. Although by now I made that mine cart set up. No, I have to get a put Silk Touch on shears. Oh well. This is always an interesting sight to see. This is supposed to be abandoned mine shaft, but I did not place this torch here. Which makes me wonder, how long has this shaft been abandoned? Can't be that long if a torch is still burning. Ooh, our first whatever. Got it. But then again, torches, I've got worlds that are like 4 years and older. So if those can still be lit, then I'm not, I guess they can just go forever. All right. I'm feeling like nothing's gonna stop me from this. Which side? Oh, that side. Don't even care. I don't even care. If I did care, maybe I should care. Look at all this free string. Like, I don't know if I was really hurting for it before, but these are wonderful. I'm actually looking out through here and seeing that it actually goes up quite a bit. So this could be a long exploration, but I think I have enough torches. I think I have enough. Do I? I don't know, remember. Was there another spawner nearby? Ha. that's. I like that reaction. Just a single ha. But you gotta mean it. Oh, this looks like one of those central areas. All right, well, if I ever need to set up shop, I like to actually use these. Ooh, level 10. Now this is the good stuff. Oh, see, this is what I'm talking about. Sometimes these get low. Three, not bad. I just wish this went further. Whenever I go to places like this, I reminisce a little bit about things because, well, you get a long time to do whatever you're gonna do, so you might as well pick something you like doing. I like reminiscing. This place hasn't changed too much since I played Minecraft, originally. But the first time I saw a mine shaft, oh boy, that scared the everything out of me. Just everything. Like, I thought I was alone in the world. Then I saw one of these. Realized I was still alone later. But for at one point, I thought, wow, are there others here? Just like me? It's probably why I think SMPs are pretty cool, because it's like you're not alone. Oh, tip for the wise, if you got mine shafts like this, if you got them, look around, you know? Just kind of, oh. You never know what you're gonna do like that. It's not gonna happen that often. That's false advertising if I was like, yeah, just find them, like, I'm gonna go find them now, and there they are. No. Don't worry, I'm saving that stuff for later. You'll know when you come across a mine shaft that I've had my way with. It's gonna be different, I'll just say that. What's good about taking this wood is that if you run out of torches, which I won't, you can just mine some coal and be on your way. That's why I like mine shaft. My only problem with mine shafts is they don't always directly connect. Like, this section is completely not connected to anything. The only reason I can see it is because there's a cave here. Oh wait, maybe I have been here before. I thought I didn't. Wait, where am I? Okay. Torch on the left. Going away. Oh, there. Does this lead out? Oh, spider spawner, all that stuff. Okay. So maybe we're cool. We're cool. Spooky corner. Oh, look. Don't have to worry. Not nearly as spooky. Still kind of spooky. Lovely pit of death. Carry on. Wait, what? The mine's right here. I thought this was just a random. Huh. It's kind of weird. There doesn't seem to be anything connecting these for a little bit. That's kind of strange. It just sort of jumped a gap. This is a huge mine. Yeah, the miners that designed this place, sometimes I wonder what they were thinking. Everywhere I think I could get severely lost, I'm just gonna make a huge pile of torches. That's pretty cool by me. Actually, I think that is a pretty good tip. If you're ever, when you're putting down torches, with the mindset of being able to guide your way back, think about looking behind you as a perspective instead of looking ahead of you. Because if I come from, say, this direction, and I think, all right, torch on the right just disappeared. I think, oh, well, if this is the way back, maybe I should put another torch on the right so I can see it. Huh? Not sure. I think there's a zombie horde somewhere. There's a welcoming party trying to find me. Oh, this is kind of cool. The tunnels are exactly next to each other. You know what? I'll bite. What's going on up here? What's going on up here? What's all the bush, the hubbub? Whoa. I hear a bunch of them. Where? There's gotta be just like a pod of like... like, I don't know. That's fun. Just, you know, sitting in the corner, facing away from anyone that could be walking toward it. That's my idea of a good time. Get off my plane! Oh, that's unfortunate for that spawner. It's really good for me. Just don't mind if I do. I'll just be, you know, reaching over here. Oops, that's not reaching. Let's light this up. Alright, so there's a dungeon. I wonder how many are down there. I've been hanging out nearby here for a little while. Where do they funnel to? Oh, there they are. There's even a creeper to sweeten the deal. I kind of want to go down there. Hey, guys, what's up? So I think down there, that's the real prize is. Everybody hanging out down there having a party. Like anybody that's anybody's down there. So that's where I'm gonna have to go, I think. Who knows, maybe there's even a spider thing down there. I don't wanna miss that. So, time to jump right in. Bring it on! Thank you, creep. Oh. It's like an ornament. Oh, okay. I wonder if baby zombies fall faster than everybody else. I know there's definitely more in here. Yeah, I bet there's a spider spawner. Whoa. Wait. You still spawning things? Potato. What? Wait a minute. Okay, here's a fun fact. There's usually only one of these rooms like this per mineshaft. Does that mean these are two? This might be two mineshafts. That would explain why it's so big. Wow. All right then. Oh, we must be close. I see a baby cave spider poison thing. Oh, there's more of them in there. All right. Ah, I was gonna show off my my awesome spider fighting skills, but I didn't. You're supposed to do a fighting retreat Like, you back up while you're swinging. Just a little bit slower than they're charging. Ooh. Can show it. Nope, nope. I hit a pole. Wonder how many are in here. Probably a lot. Oh! Oh, poked. Oh, see, like that. That's how it's supposed to do. Okay, let's light this up. I think I can go ahead and take care of that. Whoa! Just hanging out here. Didn't quite see you there. Might be good. Still hear him though. Okay, yeah, there's... Wow, there's... They just... Oh! They're stacking. They stack to hide their numbers. Very smart, actually. Blessed silence. Who's down there? Who's up here? That's actually a better question. Someone's up there. Oh. Excuse me, sir. Oh, excuse you, sir. Pinata time. Yay. Yay, pinata. Crap. There's too many. Oh. Okay. All right. Think very carefully. How'd you get here? Where'd you come from? How'd you get here? You're not answering my questions. Oh, jeez, there's more. Okay. Okay. Patience is its own reward. I'm just like inventing sayings right now to try to get me through this. Oh! Okay. Found it. When is he gonna decide to charge me? Charge me admission. Well, luckily they're getting stuck on the ceiling, so that helps. Really, I used to be so pro. What happened? Probably grew up. Was probably a kid once. It was awesome. Well, I've gone through my torches like I said I wouldn't, and I'm back. Phase one of the mine shaft is done. That is the ransack. No, wait. That's the light up. The second part is the ransack, which means I'm going to have to make room. This is what I want to see when I see a mine shaft. So I've gone around, and this is what my business looks like. If it's low enough below diamond level, I'll mine out for spots, and when I'm done with an area, I'll usually put a beam across it. Helps me keep track. So I wasn't as thorough as I could have been, but I think I made out pretty well. I definitely have a lot of fence posts now, quite a bit of string, and finally some cobweb and rails, so maybe we can do stuff with that. I kind of stopped collecting this stuff after a while, and honestly, I could have been more thorough with this place. Oh, I forgot to show the loot. Otherwise known as loot in select circles. But I think I did pretty well, especially the diamonds. And got a few specialty items. But it turned out that was a double mine shaft, and the further I got, the less thorough I got. And I think I got pretty much most of the stuff, but once my axe broke, I was pretty much done. Oh, and I also got these now. I had to enchant a book, which took almost two inventories of wooden shovels as to get through the enchants until one finally came up, but it did. But I think I'm going to end the episode there. This time, what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to maybe, if there's any more houses I want to add to the town, I'll add those. And let me think. And then maybe one final landscaping session with like trees and stuff. It should make the area look nice. But until then, this is RedMcNed. I'll see you in the next episode.